Thank you very much, Program Director. Madam Mayor, I see she's gone. MEC Grant, the leaders of the companies concerned, Gestamp, GRI, and the local management team of this particular facility, officials from the Department of Trade and Industry, other government departments that are here present, Ms. Morolo from the Industrial Development Corporation, ladies and gentlemen. Let me start off by saying that from the DTI side, I am, of course, very excited and happy to participate in the launch of this particular facility here in Atlantis today. As has already been mentioned, the green economy has been identified as a key focus area for our industrial policy action plan. And indeed, our efforts in terms of promoting industrial development are informed by the government's integrated resource program for the energy sector, which identifies a target of achieving 1/4 of the new energy needs of our country by 2030 coming from renewables. That's a large and very significant commitment to renewable energy. And I think that I wanted to make the very same point that MEC Grant made about the climate scope study by Bloomberg, which ranked us third in terms of renewable energy programs, after much bigger economies than ours, China and Brazil, and that we are responsible for 90% of the investments in the African continent in renewable energy. I could also cite that in 2013, our REI PPP won the Green Infrastructure Project of the Year at the 6th Global Infrastructure Leadership Conference in New York. Just to cite that this is a very substantial and significant program of green energy development. Now, I think the point I really want to make is that our ability to support a big shift to renewable energy, of course, making a contribution to avoiding catastrophic climate change by reducing our carbon footprint, but also our ability to do this must be driven by the ability for us to support this by bringing manufacturing development into our country and not just importing all of the goods and services that are required to establish renewable energy generation programs. And it's for that reason that working together with the Department of Energy and the National Treasury, our department has been charged with the responsibility of developing local content requirements for the Renewable Energy Independent Power Producer Program. And these have been steadily increasing over the different bid periods, so that the threshold in bid window one was 25%, and is envisaged to rise to 40% by bid window four, with a target of 40% in bid window one, rising to 60% in bid window four. The detailed localization for the three forms of renewable energy that we support here in South Africa, namely photovoltaic solar energy, compact solar energy, and wind energy, some of these are still being worked out in finer detail, but I think that is an indication that localization is a critical component of that. Now, in the wind energy space, given that I'm told that 26% of the total cost of a wind turbine is the tower, and given that the tower is in fact a bulky and also a heavy component, it just does not make sense for us to be importing these towers when we can very well make them in our own country. And it is for that reason, I think, that a number of investors have responded by investing in the manufacturing. Today's launch is in fact the second significant investment in the manufacture of wind towers. The first was the investment by DCD Dorbel in the Kucha Industrial Development Zone, with an output roughly the same as this, around about 150-odd towers a year. This is then the second of these manufacturing investments. As has already been said, the capability of creating 200 permanent jobs and an investment value of around 300 million rand. This is a significant and important second comer into this space, and I think we look forward and welcome very much this investment. Let me say that TISA has trade and investment South Africa, whose head is sitting there in the front. Yunus Hussein is the head of trade and investment South Africa. They have been working to facilitate investments with a total value of 3 billion rand in the manufacturing of equipment and components for renewable energy. So I think that the commitment and the work that's been done by all the three spheres of government working together is what's facilitated this. But the contribution of the DTI in particular is that we have been able to support this investment through the 12I tax incentive program. The allowance has been 80 million rand, with an additional 5 million rand which has been made available for the skills development part of this particular investment. Let me say that I think that the cooperation we've enjoyed is also manifest in the fact that there will be a signing of an MOU with Green Cape, which will, I think, cement the already good working relations that we have had with this particular institution working here in the city of Cape Town and in the Western Cape. The DTI has a suite of incentives to support industrial development in the country. The 12I, which this project has benefited from, is but one. Mention was made by Madam Mayor of the work which is being done to declare part of Atlantis to be a special economic zone around the green economy. Let me just report on that as we rolled out the legislation on special economic zones in the course of last year, simultaneously with that, we were working with provinces to identify and then conduct feasibility and pre-feasibility work on the potential special economic zones which could be declared once the new legislation came into force. Special economic zones are broader than the existing industrial development zones, although they are one form, but special economic zones would now also be able to include industry-specific zones like, for example, green energy. There are, in fact, two potential green energy SEZs that have been identified. The Atlantis project is one, and the other one, which I think is worth mentioning, is the solar park corridor in the Northern Cape. So there are these two. Where are we at in the process? We are in the process of recruiting the members of the advisory board that would have to give advice and look through the details of the particular proposals. But if and when SEZs are declared, what is available to investors in special economic zones are a number of additional incentives. They begin with a 15% flat corporate tax rate. There's a building tax allowance. There's an employment tax incentive. And then there's exemption from various charges like some of the customs duties and some parts of value-added tax. Let me just finally say that in addition to welcoming the fact that we will be having locally produced wind towers here in Atlantis, I can say that I am informed that this factory itself was built, as everybody said, in good time, was built by local manufacturers using local materials. So localization was also embedded in the building of this particular factory. So let me just then say that we are committed to continuing to support projects in the green economy. We believe that there is a significant space in South Africa for investments of this sort. We believe that there is a bright future for renewable energy to make its contribution to solving the energy crisis that we have in the country, which is indeed a constraint on manufacturing development more generally. And let me then welcome this investment, thank everybody who's contributed to it, and also let me then also thank our own team as the DTI, led by Eunice Hoosen, who's sitting here today. Thank you very much.